Good morning, CV.
Welcome back to another great show. Good job to all the cast and crew from the Spring Musical 9 to 5.
Celebrate CV will take place 5:30 to 7:30 on Wednesday, March 15th, where there will be fun for all.
Spring sports have started up. We wish everyone the best of luck in their upcoming seasons. Next, we have our first creative piece.
What's up? My name's Hugh Janus, and if you want to stop being a loser, listen to me. Listen to me. Listen to me. Of course, being awesome, skateboarding.
There are three things that make skateboarding awesome: wearing cool clothes, having good hair, and sunglasses. That's all it takes, baby.
Just look how good I am. I can ride this all on my own. No help even needed. First step to skateboarding, learning how to ride. Oh God, oh man. Step number two, the ollie. Step number three, hill bomb. There's a difference between skating well and looking good while doing it. Like, if you're a good skater, it doesn't matter if you know good style. Here's how to have good style while skating. Step number one, cuff your pants. Cuff your pants, the chicks dig it. If you don't cuff your pants, ladies won't want you, man. Look at this chump right here. Before his cuff pants, he was chickless. Now, chick full. Rule number two, get the hair. Look at my cameraman right here. See this hair? Chickless. Doesn't even skate. If you get hair like these luscious locks, chicks will dig you, the boys will dig you. You'll be awesome, just like me. Before, my friend here, look at this loser poser hair. Please fix him up real quick. Now look at him. Rule number three, sunglasses. Just kidding. Thanks for watching, guys. Hope you enjoyed this first episode of Hugh Janus' School of Awesomeness. If you do, like, subscribe, hit that bell. Support the GoFundMe for my child support. Really appreciate it. See you guys next time.
First up, we have this week's question of the week.
Hello, Chargers Valley High School, and today, we are going to be interviewing people to see how well they know St. Patty's Day and its events. I'm here with Jackson Specht. Now, Jackson Specht, what color is a leprechaun's hair?
Red or orange?
Yes! Here with Nicholas McCulvey. And McCulvey, what college has the leprechaun mascot?
Notre Dame.
Attaboy. Crystal, what side of the rainbow is the pot of gold on? No.
I don't know.
Yeah, me.
I'm here with Nina.
Okay.
Nina, what country does St. Patty's Day originate from?
Ireland. I can't forget like the name of the
Is that your final answer?
No, it's not, so it's wrong.
So what is it?
Iceland? I don't know.
I'm here with Justin Ferrari. And Justin Ferrari, what year was the first known celebration of St. Patty's Day in the U.S.?
Wow, I'm not going to know that. All right, 1924.
Lower.
1902.
Lower.
1851.
Lower. Gagan, what restaurant sells a St. Patty's Day themed milkshake?
McDonald's?
What is it called?
The Shamrock Shake.
Thank you, you got it right.
1799.
Lower.
1650.
Little lower.
1643.
Little lower.
1641.
Little lower.
1635.
Little lower.
1621.
Little lower.
1600.
Boom!
Lastly, we have a spotlight on the chill room.
Alright, I'm Jackson. Who am I here with today?
I'm Mr. Benz.
Nice to meet you. And what would you say some benefits are of the chill room?
Well, the chill room's a nice therapeutic space for kids to come in when they're feeling stressed or they just need a breather to settle back and maybe collect their thoughts, reassess what they're doing for the day, and to come in and just hang out.
Cool. Thank you. And then what are some things someone who wants to come up to the chill room could talk to you about?
Sometimes kids just want to talk about their day or maybe get a different perspective about what to do with certain academic issues, or sometimes kids are having problems at home. Mostly they just want a different perspective, maybe from an adult that's used to dealing with these kinds of subjects. I've dealt with teenagers for the past 12 years in all forms, so they could talk to me about anything. So academics, I'm a certified teacher. I used to teach Spanish from kindergarten all the way up to high school. So whatever, everything's on the table.
Cool. All right, and then what do you do in the chill room?
Well, what we can do, we have plenty of seating space here. Some people like to sit on this couch. You can see behind us, this is a weighted blanket. Some kids use that kind of to desensitize, maybe. We have different sounds in here, flowers. I have quotes of the day. We have over here, you can't see, but on the right, we have a workspace where people can do some coloring, drawing. A lot of kids bring their own work in. So you can come in and do work, nice quiet space. Kids come in and do their own drawings. There are a lot of options that you have here, and sometimes they don't do anything.
And the last one is, do you enjoy working in the chill room?
I think the chill room for me personally has basically gotten all of the things that I enjoy doing. I enjoy working with children. I enjoy education, teaching, and just being there for kids, students, when they need someone. So part of the aspect of this is that a lot of times kids would be going through something or they would need a space and they would have to hold off because nothing was available. I like to be the person that's available, and I make sure that we're there for the kids, and I really, really enjoy it.
Cool. Thanks for talking with us.
Thank you. Yeah. I can't stop the
The next No Place for Hate meeting will take place after school on Tuesday, March 21st until 3:30 in the DMC. All are welcome.
That's all we have for you. Have a great rest of your week.
See you guys next time on CBTV.
Emotionless.